Hello once again, YouTube, and welcome back to The Domain. Today, I'm not making this video alone. I am joined by the legendary Matty Crafts. Say hello.
Hey, hello everyone.
How's it going today, my friend?
It's been a good one. It's been a little bit more lax than some of my other days recently, so it's nice. It's nice.
As is always the way with these things, you're recording in the PM and I am the next day in the AM.
Yeah.
I know some things that are going to happen on Wednesday that you don't even know about yet. I can predict the future by 12 hours.
Yeah, you can.
All right, so welcome everybody to this new kind of video series, 10 Burning Questions. And this is also part one of two of this video series. If you would like to watch part two, it's where Matty gets to ask me 10 questions, so head over to his channel right now to check that one out. Hopefully it'll expand into this amazing series of videos where I can interview all different people from the Halo community, ask them questions that I have, that my Discord has, and that my Patreon supporters have. And we've got 10 questions here today to ask to Matty Crafts, which I'm sure the large majority of people in the Halo Mega Constructs community are very well aware of his work. Matty, why don't you give yourself just a quick introduction? What do you do on YouTube?
I've been a YouTuber for around 9 months now. I basically focus on Halo Mega Constructs and crafting side of things. I bring over a lot of different materials like styrofoam and clay, customize a lot of figures, and I try my best to recreate some stuff that Mega can't make.
Really? The emphasis is there. 11 months, that is not a long amount of time for the sheer volume of videos you've put out. I mean, you put out a lot more videos than like most big Halo YouTubers would do in 11 months. You've been working hard.
It's been a grind. It's been a grind, and I've been slowing down a little bit, kind of focusing more on the quality of videos. It's been an amazing journey. I love making content for people.
That's fantastic. That's fantastic. So we've got about 10 questions here that are going to delve into your past, your future, and sort of what makes you tick as a Halo YouTuber. Question number one, I did a little bit of deep diving into your YouTube channel and found your very first video, the Halo 1 Covenant versus Flood Mock. It's an interesting one, you know, there's no audio. How far do you think you've come since that first video? Only 11 months ago.
I've definitely come a long way from the first video. That video was made on my old phone and I didn't even have an editing software I could actually make a video with.
Right.
My computer wouldn't port over the video itself, so I had to just use pictures. I had no audio. It was a mess, but it was the start of something much bigger. Being able to do that in that first step for anyone, and also where I've come, like watching other YouTubers like yourself or other people in the Mega Constructs community or even outside of that, it helps tremendously in getting inspiration.
It does, yeah. I always like to go back to my very first videos. It was just some super clunky animations. When I first made videos, like I was experimenting with a lot of things. I did loads of gameplay. I did a Minecraft YouTube channel at one point. Like I was doing all sorts of different things. And then what stuck for me was Halo, because I uploaded these animations and suddenly there was like this little community that was supporting me, which was so nice. Really, that leads into my second question. You know, in your channel before, you've done Star Wars videos, Bloodborne, some Skyrim mocks. Like, what made Halo stick for you?
I made all these other things, and I wanted to originally be a D&D YouTuber. D&D, for me, is something I've always played. I've played with it for about 2 years with my friends, you know, going to Dark Basement, hang out, talk about nerdy stuff.
Oh, yeah.
And it's always been an enjoyable thing, but when I was growing up, Halo was always there. My first ever Halo video did really well. I think it got, like, 400 views. I was like, okay, well, maybe this is something I can build upon, and I have ever since.
Yeah, at the beginning, you've kind of just got to experiment with what works, and find a genre that you can stick with. Yeah. When you're talking about Halo, like, what main YouTube channels, like, have always inspired you? Like, even way back when, like, what did you remember growing up? Like, what Halo channels would you watch growing up?
A lot of the hidden lore, like Halo Follower, Hidden Xperia, those guys, the Halo lore was always really interesting. I used to watch a lot of multiplayer stuff too. Actually, the funny thing is, before I even became a YouTuber, I watched some of your stuff when I was younger. And it's really weird being in the position that I am in now, because now I'm talking to you like 5 years, 6 years ago. I didn't even know really who you were, but I've seen your stuff. So it's like a full circle thing, and it's really cool.
How about that?
Kind of come around.
I really hope that one day I'll be interviewing some of those big Halo YouTubers. And Hidden Xperia, I think he turned like 25 last month or something.
Mm-hmm.
Like, those people have been grinding since the beginning, but doing really well. Halo Followers had a bit of a rocky experience. I don't really vibe with all of his clickbait titles. I mean, he just, he asks for bad press. I definitely, when I was growing up on my Halo Mega Bloks journey, my biggest inspiration was Commander Bakara and obviously Jang Bricks. Like, I always thought they were like in a huge league. Philip V98, he was another classic name. Then I'm just looking through all your videos and really, yes, you have been grinding them out. You've been on pretty much a video every single day for a long time now. And I think I might know the answer to this, but what would you say is your proudest build?
That is so hard. 90 to like 85% of the stuff I make, I really don't like.
Oh, really?
And it's strange because I'm more of an artist than I am anything else. When you're an artist and you're looking at something, you find like the weirdest things to pick out of it. And you're like, I just don't like that piece, but other people might love it. I would probably say one of the things that I love the most that I've made is probably the Flood Cult. That one, the Banished Scarab's really good. One of my Grave Mines is cool. I've made two. It's kind of hard sometimes, but what did you think it was?
I definitely thought you were going to pick the Scarab, but yeah, I also really enjoyed that Flood Cult as well. And if you guys already didn't know, me and Matty did a collab a while ago. I did a reaction video to his top three mocks. It's a great video. You should definitely check that one out. And that goes into your schedule issue, because I saw you posted a video a few days ago saying you might start taking it from 7 days a week to 3 to 4 days a week on your upload cycle.
I think what I was doing for a long time is I had this idea in my mind that, okay, if I'm going to be a YouTuber like I want to be and I'm going to be putting out content, one, I love making content for people. I love the idea of someone watching it, commenting, liking the video, and kind of brightening up people's day. Sure. I find that really enjoyable. I think it just got to be too much work-wise. And I want to do bigger and better projects as well. And having a one-day schedule and a one-day time limit of, okay, I wake up at 9, I create something, I mold it, I sculpt it, I paint it, and then I have to have the video out by 8.
It's pressure. It's real pressure.
It's a lot of pressure for sure. So having a more relaxed schedule helps me out a lot in making actual better content, I think.
Well, you're preaching to the converted there. I mean, I had a similar issue when I first moved to Hong Kong back in August time. I dedicated myself to uploading every single day. And really at the time, you know, it's a logical step because it gets into that YouTube algorithm, like people get more content, more subscribers, but you're just not delivering the same quality of content.
No.
So I've definitely relaxed my schedule a little bit now. Like, I'm not going to do an 8-hour teaching day and still know that I've got to push out a video at midnight. It's not going to happen.
That's a lot.
Don't put the pressure on yourself is the number one advice from me. Like, the second you stop enjoying YouTube, it just doesn't become worth it. If you are going to relax that schedule, you know, the next question is sort of, where do you see yourself in 5 years with this channel? Do you see yourself evolving into different content? Do you think you'll still be uploading regularly? Like, do you think this is something you're going to keep up?
I love it. It's a funny story because when I was younger, I would always watch these Minecraft YouTubers, which is funny because you brought that up earlier.
Yeah.
And I had so much enjoyment watching them every single day, and I loved it, and it was just great. So when I got older and I was working at a facility, and then I got done with that, and I didn't really know what I wanted to do with a direction in my life. I thought, okay, well, maybe let's just make a YouTube channel and have some fun, see what happens. Time on my hands. So I did that, and it started to pick up, and I think I would love to branch out. Halo is always going to be a focus point for me, but it's not going to be there for forever. I think I'm going to be doing anything from Skyrim, Cyberpunk, Apex.
Oh, yeah.
Halo is amazing and great, but if I focus too much on it, I lose inspiration. So to be able to focus on other things as well, while still putting out Halo content, I think in 5 years, in a month, in however long, I think of new stuff all the time, and I'm always changing it up. So I definitely will be doing YouTube in 5 years.
That's a fantastic answer, yeah. And you do need to branch out. Like, I hope that slowly I'm going to branch out into more general Halo news, maybe some Xbox. Like, you need to continue to do that or your content does become stale. So that's great to hear as well. And the last question from me today before we hand it over to my Discord, where do you buy all your materials? Because when I look online, these like styrofoam blocks, they are expensive.
I get my stuff from a local store called Home Depot and Michaels and craft stores. And I pretty much buy everything local. A big thing of styrofoam for me is pretty cheap actually. And that's actually been a worry of mine. When I move out and I move to a different state one day, am I going to be able to find everything that I need? Yeah. That's always been on my mind, but construction stores normally have those kind of materials and any of the basic materials that you'll need.
Okay, fantastic. That is the 7 burning questions that I had personally, and then I opened it up to the Discord, where if you guys are not already members of our Discord, it's a fantastic community to be in, to talk Halo or Mega Constructs, whatever you want. And every time I make one of these videos, I ping everybody in the channel and you can ask your questions. The first one is from Halo Mock Maker. And his question is, what was your first ever Halo Mega Block set?
Ooh, that is hard.
Oh yeah?
That is hard. I remember when I was younger, I went into the toy section and I got a couple of, like, the old original Series 1 blind bags, and I also got the red Hornet, I believe. That one was really fun, and it had like the sniper jackal tower as well.
The red Hornet is my all-time favorite set.
I think I do remember that from one of your videos, yeah.
The Series 1 blind bags, the very first figure I ever got was a Series 1 blind bag, and it was the AC Spartan, and it just started from there, yeah. Okay, next one is from Demo Pan with a question mark. What is your biggest custom that you think you could possibly make?
I would absolutely love to make the Halo 3 Believe trailer. Again, like when I first loaded up that game from playing Halo CE and playing Halo 2, there's legitimate emotions that I felt at the end of that game. If you're a real Halo fan and you kind of dig deep and you understand what the original trilogy really meant and what Bungie actually did for us, that would be probably my favorite thing that I would ever make.
I was hoping that you would say a new Mombasa diorama, but whatever, you know.
That
you
could happen too.
You want to make the entirety of new Mombasa with the big gravity tower being blown up by the slip space bomb. That would be pretty cool. And the last one is from, and this is his name, Long Strokey Banana Man III. And his question is, will you ever build a massive eggplant?
If it's flood based, I might just have to. I could make that work.
Some kind of weird flood.
I could make it into like it could have
organism.
Holes, and then the inside of the holes could have like flood like infection forms shooting out. Yeah, we could make that work.
What if you just got like a load of vegetables and fruit and left them to mold for like a week?
Oh right.
And
right.
then just put some flood inside.
That's just a free video right there.
We have gone down the 10 questions. 7 from me, 3 from our Discord. Now we're going to go over to our Patreon. If you're a member of my Patreon, you can join an exclusive Discord community, and any question you ask will be answered by our guest. The first one is from Panzer, and he asks, what paints do you use for your customs?
So for the longest time, if you're just getting into like something that you can be proud of and just put on a shelf, Apple Barrel paints or anything that you can really find that's cheap, as long as you use a primer. Primer spray cans, you can just find in the spray painting section of like Walmart. But if you really want to make quality customs, I would say Citadel paints is very good. People from Warhammer 40K to D&D use those kind of paints, and they're extremely high quality.
I love Citadel paints. I love them. Yep. And the last question is from Halo MC Collector. What is your favorite mystery pack?
Clash on the Ring. It would have to be the Marines, just because I'm gonna redo like 20 of them one day and make like all of the Halo CE Marines, like different forms, Sergeant Johnson and all that. So just because I have so many, so I can kind of make like a traditional CE, just because Halo CE is a special spot in my heart.
Well, Matty, that has been, I guess, a total of 12 questions asked to you from the domain to Matty Crafts. Guys, if you have not checked out Matty Crafts' YouTube channel, you're just not playing. You need to head over to that link right now and subscribe. He is just pumping out all these insane customs from all your favorite Halo games, the most iconic scenes. It's just the place to be in the Mega Constructs community right now. And this is only part one of this video series. Part two, you can head over to Matty Crafts' channel, and he's going to ask me 10 questions. So if you'd like to check that out, hear my behind the scenes of whatever he's going to ask me, I don't know. Head over to Matty Crafts' channel, check it out. And as always, thank you very much for tuning in today. Matty, thank you so much for being on the show. And
thank you for having me.
Answering all of our burning questions. This was another video with The Domain, signing off.